John Mulholland is a writer and a documentary filmmaker that's currently writing and directing a feature documentary about the 20-year friendship of Gary Cooper and Ernest Hemingway. And it's being produced by MODA Entertainment New York, and he's here with us. And I want to welcome him up to talk a little about his documentary. John Mulholland. When did they meet? Did they know each other when he did A Farewell to Arms?
No, but Hemingway was well aware of it. He had written to Owen Wister in 1831 that we're not just joined as writers, we're now joined by Gary Cooper. He did Your Virginia, and he's doing My Farewell to Arms. They didn't meet until 1940, but throughout the 30s, Hemingway had remarked to friends that this actor, Gary Cooper, and I have the same style, same approach to our class. Much of what we do, it's understated, it's very spare. And then in 1938, he tried to meet Cooper. I had friends call Cooper. They couldn't get together. They talked on the phone. 39, the same thing. And 40, they met. And at that time, Hemingway said to Cooper that he had written from the Bell Tolls for him, Bible, Robert Jordan on him.
So was it always a foregone conclusion that Cooper would do that film?
It was certainly Hemingway's foregone conclusion. Yeah, he gave him advanced copy of the book. Cooper read it, said, yes, I want to do it.
And then did they click just right away as friends?
Immediately went hunting the next day. And for 21 years, and ups and downs and that, but it, two extraordinary men. Hemingway, there's this image of Hemingway that he was a hairy-chested masculinity and that sort of thing, that smash mouth, and he wasn't that at all. His heroes, which is why Cooper was the ideal screen image for Hemingway. They were men who looked for ways to preserve life, not to take it. It's a shame, the image of Hemingway that's spread now, and I hope somehow in this documentary we can correct that.
I wanted to ask also, were they people that shared thoughts with each other, or did they just share time together and feel comfortable with each other?
I think they shared thoughts with each other. There's an image of Cooper as a yup and nope man and not much else. But here's a man who, numbered among his very good friends, John O'Hara, Irwin Shaw, Picasso. Robert Sherwood wrote the play Abe Lincoln in Illinois for Cooper. And he asked him to play it on Broadway, and Cooper said, I don't think I can do that. But he's a man of considerable substance, an elegant man, a bright man. No, they exchanged thoughts. They had problems politically occasionally.
And did they stay close up until the time that, which died first?
Cooper died first in May. Cooper had called Hemingway in late March and said on the phone, I'll bet I beat you to the barn. And did, in fact, one of the things that led to Hemingway's very deep depression was Cooper's illness and eventual death. It was, his son Jack had mentioned that to me, that really sent him into a downward spiral. He had become in real life the image that Hemingway had, and to see this man shredded away was devastating.
Were there any other projects that they almost worked on together?
They had been trying to get for 10 years the novel, The Crow's Turban, Into the Trees off the ground, and finally in 1959-60, they were putting a company together to do it themselves. Also, Fred Zinnemann, who was very close to both Cooper and Hemingway, and Hemingway and Cooper were looking for something to do together.
What a combination that would be.
Yeah.
So what, at what status is your documentary now?
We have around a month more to do some shooting, including yourself. And then we'll go into the editing room, and we hope to have it ready for the theaters by December.
Great. Well, good luck on it. Thanks for being here. Thanks for sharing that.